قد غم مردم خوردیم ای مادر غم خور شده حرفت ورد زبونا الجاس همت داد دلم از این می سوزت اومد.
It's because of Fatimiya that our history starts to reveal itself. It's because of Fatimiya that even Ashura and Badir begin to miss. Fatimiya makes it such that it makes sense. It's because of Fatimiya that our history starts to reveal itself. It's because of Fatimiya that even Ashura and Ghadir begin to make sense. Without Fatimiya, Ashura would have been a cataclysmic event, an earth-shattering occurrence. It would have changed the course of history as it does. It would have been something that is mentioned in history books forever and ever, no doubt. But it would have left Ashura as this mysterious, enigmatic, unexplainable event. Again, remove Fatimiya from the equation. Remove the attack on the house of prophethood. Remove the ambush on the home of Fatima and Ali. Ashura doesn't make much sense. Ashura would have been extremely mystifying and enigmatic. People would have struggled, we would have struggled to explain what exactly happened in Ashura. How could the nation that proclaims a fellowship to the Holy Prophet and who stood up to pray in celebration after they killed and massacred Abu Abdullah al-Hussein. That's how they celebrated their victory. They all got up and they prayed to Allah. How could this nation murder the grandson of this prophet? We would have been confused until the day of judgment. It's only when you take into consideration Fatimiya that it begins to make sense. It's only when you think that this snowball was actually thrown on the day of Saqifa and it ended up picking up more and more snow and dirt and rocks and pebbles until it all materialized on the 10th day of Muharram in the year 61 after the Hijrah of the Holy Prophet. Only then will you realize that this arrow came from the direction of the Saqifa. And so Fatimiya is absolutely critical to our worldview. Fatimiya is what allows us to make sense of the madness, the chaos, the mayhem, the pandemonium that transpired after the death of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. And so once again, if we were to choose, it would have to be Fatimiya. Some people call Fatimiya the second Ashura. But I posit that it has to be even before Ashura. Some people call the 9th of Rabi' the second Ghadir. But the 9th of Rabi' again makes it all clear. And incidentally, they both relate to Fatima to Zahra alayhi salam.
Mazlum